Live from the basement of the VRS Multiplex, it's the WoW Radio Show with your hosts and grand eaters, Justin Snodgrass and Richie the Redneck Nip. Alright.
And good morning. We are waiting on Richie to show up, but he'll be fashionably late. You'll see him come through the door back there. Obviously, you can see we're in a little bit different location than normal. So, excuse me. We're in a transition period here for the WoW Radio Show, and we've got some big news coming up here later on in the show. We will also be letting you know how you can support the show. Right here at VRS. Make sure you smash the hell out of that share button. Good morning, High Tech Redneck. Good morning. Oh, hey, there is the man, the myth, and the legend, Richie King. How you doing, brother? A little bit on the running late side. What, did you get some morning nookie for you or something? Jesus.
No, I had to figure out how to navigate where Cameron was.
No, oh, Jesus. Are you that high still?
No, I'm coming down. I quit taking him about Tuesday, 3:30. I'll tell you what. Those things are wicked.
Yeah.
I went out to
Crazy dreams.
Well, I went out. You know I live deep in the country.
Oh, yeah.
I just pee outside. I don't care. Right?
Right.
I go outside to pee, and I guess I'm out there 25 minutes. The wife comes out and says, "What the hell are you doing?" I said, "I'm out here to pee." She goes, "Well, pee." I said, "I can't find the toilet." She goes, "Get your stupid ass back inside the house. What is wrong?" I guess I wandered around the yard looking for the toilet.
Oh, Jesus.
Man, it's just some crazy. These things are just nuts.
High Tech says, good morning to you, and glad to see you're not looking nearly as high as you were last week.
No, thank you. I did a show last night in Gladstone.
Good. How'd it go?
Man, I gotta give a shout out. Them people in Gladstone are some good folks. We just loved them. We had a good time there. Quite a few people showed up. We broke the record.
Really?
Yeah. Of course, awesome. The one the record was two. We put four in the chair.
There you go.
But we did
maybe we'll break a record for fans of the show and get four instead of three.
Yeah, I hope so. I got up on a stage and the painkillers all wore off, but the lights, something about the lights.
Oh, man.
I just sweating my butt off.
Oh, yeah, those cool lights show. Get hot as hell.
Jeff, right before the show, you know, Jay, he was announcing it. My turn to come up.
Yeah.
Jeff grabbed me by the arm, and he was taking me to the steps, and he was kind of gingerly helping me up there. They were eating that up. We had a good time.
That's one, by the way. That's your one for the show. But anyway, I'll forgive you this time since it's your first show back in a couple of weeks. But anyway,
because at my house, I can have anything.
Let's see. Oh, Bill just checked in from down in Australia, so good eye.
Good day, mate.
Our buddy down there, High Tech Redneck, checking in. Josh Miller at Lunchbox is checking in.
Lunchbox.
Josh says, Lunchbox says, "What the fuck were you taking, LSD or shrooms?"
Well, I'm not sure.
Not sure yet.
No. It says on there, "Do not drink and take these." Well, I don't read very well. I'm half illiterate. I'm half illiterate and half stupid. Okay, so
Hey, Frank Urban just joined us. What's up, Frank? How you doing, brother? Haven't seen him in a minute, but I've got we've got some good news for the show, as well as me personally.
Well, we get a check?
No, not yet.
Somebody want to donate to you.
Right, and we'll get into that here shortly as well. As far as supporters of the show, if somebody wants to help support us, we'll get into some of that. But did you know we're getting a new location for the show?
Well, I've heard a birdie tell me that.
Yeah,
And that's good because you know we've earned it.
Yeah, we've busted our asses.
We've come up from two fans to three.
Right,
we've earned a new facility.
Right. So
yeah, it's good news for you, man. I'm glad to hear you.
Well, and it.
What in the flying is that?
I knew doing this in the office was a bad idea today. But anyway,
it's a nice day to be outside. Well, you
deal with your transition. High tech. Anyway.
But he said he's jealous of us because we're awesome.
I guess. Well, and see, the guys over at BB Nation, they've got this camper that they do their show in, and I'm not throwing a shot at them. I'm happy for them.
No,
I'm glad they've got
see
that
it.
Ability. Yeah. You know, I can't wait to actually do the show with them in the camper.
Absolutely.
But I just got told that, you know, by my landlord that I can move to the house that we really, really want, and it's great because we were up there Thursday night. And we were standing out on our front porch. We were actually up there for like 2.5 hours. And you probably know right where the house is.
I do. I know where the house is. I know who you're renting from. Down by the old Head Start.
Yeah. Well, we stood out on, you know, we were working around, you know, cleaning up a little bit and stuff. And literally in the hour and a half, 2 hours we were there, we heard one car go by. Yeah. One car, dude. And it's like, here at my house now, it's nonstop. There's, and I'm not even on one of the main drags in town.
No, you're not. Matter of fact, you're back out of the way a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I'm three blocks off the main bag, but Yeah. That's actually from the computer, but
That's one to you too then.
Uh-oh. High Tech says the studio will not be with us at Warrior Fest. Oh no. We'll talk about that after the show.
That was supposed to be part of the guarantee of you coming down.
Right, you know, the casting couch and all that. But anyway, so, you know, we've got a full basement, basically, to build. We're going to build a studio down there. Right. And, you know, I was talking about my plans for it and everything with J-Dub from BB Nation. And he was like, "That's not a studio, that's a murder room." But anyway, you know, it's a big step for us. It'll take us a couple of months probably to get the funding and the materials and everything to put the studio up. But once it starts going up, it's going to go up quicker than hell. So,
yeah.
But real quick, I do want to give a shout out to all of our sponsors here at the WoW Radio Show and VRS, warriorpointwithane.org. Become one of the uncommon few. You've seen them on the video, on the intro video. And then Grunt Style, which I'm wearing a Grunt Style shirt today.
I noticed you didn't have your...
Yeah, well, I've got something else going for that. So, excuse me. You know, head over to Grunt Style, check them out. They've got a lot of good quality shirts. I mean, these are actually fairly, you know, decent quality shirts. I mean, they're good and thick. They've got a lifetime guarantee on them. You can mail it back to them, and they will send you a new one.
Right.
And there's just, you know, they've got the mystery shirt, which you'll never be disappointed. I actually got I went ahead and said, you know, screw it, I'm gonna get one of the mystery shirts. And so I did, and you know, a couple weeks later, boom! It showed up, and I was like, oh god, I'm gonna get like some pink foo-foo marshmallow shirt or something, and
some candy
and,
ass,
yeah, some candy ass shirt, and you know, it ended up being actually a really good, you know, it was a really cool shirt, and then I became part of the Grunt Style Club, which is $20 a month. They send you a shirt every month. And I did that for a while, and then I just kind of, you know, finances got tight and stuff, so I had to cancel out. But with that being said, guys, make sure you also, if you're Minnie from the Bar just joined us, what's up, Minnie? Make sure you also head over to Lux Construction LLC here on Facebook. If you got a project that you want getting done, have you seen the house?
I went out there.
Started siting it. We've got
not started siting it. No.
Yeah. We've got it about I would say probably 75% on siting.
Nice.
The roof's all the way on and everything like that. Hi, Mom.
Hey.
So we've got, you know, and it looks good. It looks great. We finished up the side of the garage yesterday on siding, and dude, that blueprint that we've been reading on that thing, I swear there's been some 0311s with crayons that drew that thing.
Well, it was drew in the '70s.
How much LSD was the guy on whenever he drew it?
There's three copies and none of them match.
Really?
I'm telling you right now. I've been in construction for 25 years. He handed me three of them, thinking, which one you want? These are all the same. I said, I'll kiss your ass if they're all the same. One's got a ledger and a material list. Mm-hmm. One, you got to figure it out yourself. And the other one's good luck. And they all trapped in the fire. They all stink to high hell. Yeah. You know?
But anyway, so we've got that going. There's, you know, and it's just, you know, if you need a deck built, if you need anything, get a hold of Lux Construction. And they will, you know, Eric will come out and give you a quote. You know, he won't bullshit you. He won't, you know, Philly fart around on it. He'll tell you what he thinks. And then who's our other sponsor?
You got Lutz, you got Eye Candy.
Yeah, Deluxe Racing. And Conger Racing. Eye Candy's the one that made our beautiful shirts over here. And then the All-Star Rock Bar, All-Star Grill and Bar down in Kansas City. That is the venue for Warrior Fest.
Right. I got some information on that, but go ahead.
And I will be down on September 15th. I will be with Maximus at the All-Star Rock Bar to talk about Warrior Fest. So,
what time?
I'm not sure. I think about 7 o'clock is whenever it actually starts. So, but I think Blackie's going to pull me up on stage by the way he's talking, and we'll talk about Warrior Fest and everything like that. Speaking of Warrior Fest, if you want tickets, Head over right now to PayPal. You can buy your tickets for $30 for both days. So you've got 16 bands, 2 days of music, fun, comedy. You can meet our ugly asses. I don't know who would want to do that, but you can meet our ugly asses, hang out, you know, enjoy some good food. I mean, the food there at the bar is phenomenal. It's better than any bar food I've ever had in my life. And then enjoy some good music and some good times.
And meet the guys from BV Nation.
Meet
many,
the guys from
all
BV Nation. Many. Yeah. I think Proby might be showing up.
Excellent.
Anderson Cooper might be. I mean, Tom Brickner might be there.
There might be some shenanigans, games being played.
There's going to be shenanigans.
And last night, I found out we got to add a little extra to that. Not only am I going to be at Warrior Fest while I'm up there,
yeah,
but I'm also going to be leapfrogging. I'm going to be back where I was last night.
Really?
November 9th and 10th. Yeah. They requested us to come back.
Cool.
For the American Legion. The American Legion's written out to Groundhog Theater.
Right on.
Specifically asked for Comedy Fest to come back here. So now Jeff's trying to figure out how in the flying hell is he going to get everybody here?
Right, right.
Well, since I'm doing one set Saturday, one set Sunday.
Right.
And then, because Friday night is a matinee, so we just go to that.
Yeah.
You know, so I do a morning and do everything with these guys. Do that. I'll just stay up there.
Yeah.
And then we'll do the show.
Yeah.
With the boys Saturday morning.
Easy breezy.
I'll be double dipping up there. And
there you go.
Guys can come out. And our friends from BV Nation, they can come in.
Yeah.
Because I believe it's veterans getting free anyway.
Yeah, I think so.
And so they just come out, and watch double show. You know, get a good, you know.
Yeah, that's phenomenal. So, and then, you know, and honestly, over at the Rockstar Rock Bar, there's tons of stuff going on over there. It seems like every night of the week they've got something, whether it's an open mic of some sort. They've got a jazz night. They've got an open mic comedy night. They've got an acoustic night. They've got rock bands that come in and stuff like that. They've got all kinds of stuff. So it comes down to, you can't not go. You know, and I mean, I've been busy as hell with this, getting ready for this move and everything.
I wrote a special joke for Biscuit.
Oh, no.
That I'm going to tell at Warrior Fest.
Oh, God.
And I'll give you a hint. It's about lotion.
I figured.
Special needs. And I might even do some singing.
Okay, so bring earplugs to Warrior Fest.
Yeah, and y'all going to love it because, you know, just go look up Clarence Carter. Stroking. That's all I need to tell you.
Oh,
but I wrote a joke. It's clean. For the most part.
There's
some innuendo in there. And I worked on it, and he heard me saying it. Oh, he flipped a lid. I'm going. I said, technically, you're in school Friday, so you can't go.
Right.
And you're under 18. I ain't sure you can go. He goes, well, I'll call Justin. I said, well, won't you just call Justin?
Yeah.
Your friend and buddy.
Yeah. Yeah. The one that's always trying to get him to do internship.
Intern. No, you're not intern. Oh, now he's on intern. All you guys is intern. Oh.
Really?
Oh, because you want to go. You can take a paintball gun to
really?
Ass?
Right. Yeah.
No.
Then you're not the intern anymore.
I'm not sure you can get Rock Fest then.
So, Warrior Fest. Yeah. So that's, you know, and you can buy your tickets on PayPal. The email address that you enter in is theworadioshow@gmail.com. While we're talking about that, if somebody wants to buy one of these beautiful shirts that Richie's wearing, and I'll hold one up.
Hey, Vanna. You gonna be Vanna? Yeah, he's being Vanna.
Well, we'll both be Vanna. How about that? Here's our shirts. Send... This one's a large. We've got, I think we've got through 2X, I believe. But
yeah.
I've got to go check our stock.
We need inventory that, actually.
But anyway.
I know we got up to 2X because I knew I could wear one. That's
right.
Where I got mine. So, yeah, we
right.
got 2X.
So, we've got up to 2X right now.
We got a few of them. We got, you know.
Yeah, we've got a few left. If you would like to support the show, send $25 to, you know, through PayPal, the same email address, theworadioshow@gmail.com. The $5 extra is actually, they're normally $20. The $5 extra is actually to help cover shipping. And then you guys just, you know, send your name and address in the comment with it, and we will get that out. Normally, I try and ship everything on a Friday because I get off work early and I can actually make it to the post office before
and
they
it's
close.
Payday.
Yeah, and it's payday. So, with that being said, guys, let's get into our topic of the day, which can
I can't get that my side open.
It's being goofball. But anyway, so we, we were talking about earlier in the week. I kind of asked you, I said, well, what do you want to do as a topic? And you're like, well, I don't know. Let's think about it. And I said, all right, And I was expecting Richie to call me back with something off the wall and goofy, and he never did. So
you're lucky I even picked up my phone.
Right. So I kind of, I was sitting there. I was thinking about it. And I went, you know what? Recovery. You're in recovery right now. But there's different forms of recovery. There's physical. Obviously you fell off of a 20-foot ladder, bruised a couple of ribs, and
you know what?
There's no thing. Ladders going to be at Warrior Fest, by the way. Well, damn. If there are, you're not allowed around them.
Damn, I ain't afraid of them. So I'll get back on a ladder, but I'm going up about this high.
Yeah, I'll go up the first rung. That's it. But mental recovery, and not just for guys dealing with post and girls, sorry, and ladies.
And ladies.
We love our ladies. Dealing with post-traumatic stress and anxiety and depression or whatever.
And the families.
Right, and the families as well.
Yeah.
It's imperative. And actually, this actually came out of, as everybody knows, I see a therapist and I am in the VA. This actually came out of my conversation with my therapist last night or yesterday afternoon. You've got to kind of, and if you watched the show last week, I had an anxiety attack last week prior to the show. And part of the reason that happened, I wasn't giving myself time to decompress. And that's something that I've got to work on personally, because a lot of times I do give myself a chance to decompress. It's just, and then there's those times where I just try and take everything on myself and I don't give myself any time to relax. And part of it is, this show is a big decompressor for me. I love doing it. I have a blast, and it's funny because I'm an introvert. I don't like people. I don't like groups of people, but I'm a talk show host. me and my therapist had a Juan Zamora, how you doing? You've got to find and the thing is, and I've said it on the show before, the spectrum that you fall in really kind of depends on your personality. You can actually, as far as, well, and just
you're
bear
right.
with me for
no,
a second.
No, you're right, you're right.
If you think about it, okay, on one, on the far right side of the spectrum, you've got the extreme adrenaline junkie, the guy that goes out and base jumps and bungee jumps and, all the crazy, super high adrenaline sports. And then on the other end, you have what I call pothead relaxed, okay? Think about, the guy that just wants to go out and the people that mom's dealing with just heard me say pothead relax and are like, what in the hell is he talking about?
He's throwing a dime bag.
But, they kind of tend to lean towards that far left side of the spectrum where simply just sitting out in the middle of the woods doing absolutely nothing is, the most relaxing thing. It gives them time to recover and just regroup their thoughts and whatever.
Right.
And I'm actually one of those few that falls right smack in the middle.
Okay.
I could go out and sit in the woods on one day, and the very next day I want to go do 300 mile an hour down a track in a funny car. It's just it really depends on what I'm dealing with and how I'm dealing. You know, one of my favorite things in the world to do is go fishing.
Love it. Love fish.
You know, I love to go out. And honestly, there's been days where I've gone out and Juan Zamora says, what is an anxiety attack?
It's hard to explain.
It is hard because it hits everybody a little bit different.
Yeah, there's really no explanation. Like PTSD is a form of anxiety.
Yeah.
Bipolar is more of a it's not a trigger. Bipolar is a trigger. PTSD is a trigger. Bipolar is organic. Okay, so it's hard to, it hits everybody. Some people can sweat, they get into a crowd of people and they shake. That's anxiety to that person. Some people get in and all they want to do is talk. That's his anxiety.
Right,
Some people get in a crowd and want to beat the people up. That's anxiety.
Stan, we're sorry about the camera. It's the table's not very stable that we're using today. So anytime any of us move, the camera moves a little bit. So we do apologize for the camera shake.
And one thing, as you're recovering, also age has a lot to do with it too.
Yeah.
Okay. You're exactly down the center. Yeah. As you get older, you're going to say,
lean.
I don't want to go 110 mile an hour.
Yeah.
75 will work.
Yeah. Yeah. And so it's kind of one of those things that, and actually we have a birthday here on the show tomorrow.
Who's?
Mine. Oh. And then Rachel's will be next Saturday, I believe.
Sweet.
So,
yeah. Ask what was all around.
The peanut gallery in the back just said the 8th. I know it's the 8th. I was trying to figure out what day of week it was. So, 35 years old and she still messes with me. So,
she's your mama.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. She brought me into the world. She can take me right back out.
You may not stand in point. Let's go a little further with this.
Okay.
Some cultures handle things different, depressed different. I started getting in touch with my culture. You know, I'm Native American, and I started figuring out what's going on. And I talked to someone. They said, "Well, you need to pick a side." I said, "Pick a side? I might have a war." They said, no, war. You can't live white man way and Native American way. They just don't mix very well. Pick a side. You can be who you are.
Right.
Pick a side. And so I got looking into that. Well, a lot of Native Americans are real spiritual people.
Right.
Okay. So I'm currently in the process.
Not to be confused with religious.
Yeah, they are very different. They are very different. I'm currently, me and my dad, and you've met my dad before. He's religious also. But we're building a prayer circle, okay?
Right on.
And then we're going to get us a sweat lodge so we can decompress. That's how we do it. We go to a sweat lodge, we sit there and shut up. That's going to be hard for me not to talk.
Right.
Instead of money, buddy, or whatever hell the monks do it. So, and some cultures decide that's how they do it. They've been doing this for hundreds and thousands of years, decompressing like that their own way. And yet people think they can change on that. People think they can. No. Guys, you got to.
Well, yeah. And it's one of those things that, and it may work for you and it may not. Depends exactly until you try it. Right. And that's the big thing is, open your mind, and I know as vets, we don't like change. But if you open your mind to new ideas, and not to sound all new agey and stuff, but here's a big one, okay? Your house, right? Your home, your domain. When you walk in, are you relaxed or are you on edge?
Sometimes both.
Right.
But majority of the time?
Pretty relaxed.
Yeah.
Okay. My house.
Unless you fall off a 20-foot ladder.
Well, that's
25 years.
25 years and first time you've fallen off a ladder. I thought I was going to fall off the ladder yesterday. It was windier than shit. But, and it's funny because, okay, do you like doing siding?
Yeah. I love construction.
But I'm talking about siding in general.
Mm-hmm. Vinyl.
Yeah.
Georgia Pacific.
You're one of the few people I've met that actually likes doing siding, and I'm one of them. I love doing the tedious. I don't know why. It just plays to my mind. It makes me
because you're more of a finish
focus.
Guy.
Yeah,
guys get people paid. You're the guy that gets me paid. Finish. Yeah.
But on the same note, it's one of those things. Like I can take my time. Stan Moore. I've been afraid to walk out of my house for quite a while now.
Why?
Stan, we'll get into that in just a minute.
Yeah, hold that thought, Stan.
Because I and that is something I wanted to touch on today. But your home, okay, in the grand scheme, 9 times out of 10, your house, your home, your domain should be where you're the most relaxed. You should have the least amount of stress there. Mm-hmm. You should have the least, you know, it should be an environment of comfort. The energy, not to sound all new age, but the energy in your house should almost instantly calm you when you're there. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, sometimes it's external factors that cause that home not to be that way, like my house now. And then on the flip side of it, some people, you know, their house is so, what's the word I'm looking for? Chaotic. Right? You know, they've got 47,000 kids in the house. They've got, you know, they're always fighting with their significant other, blah, 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 blah. Their house is more of a battleground than it is a safe haven. And, you know, where's and Stan, or for the fear of losing your house. Yeah, true. But the big thing is you know, you move into the idea of, if, okay, perfect example. You came out as you got out of the military as a combat vet. You know, for the past 4 to however many years, you've known combat every year because you've been to Iraq, Afghanistan, whatever, okay? You come home after all of that. You should be in a safe haven. You should be in a place that's not a combat zone. But because of the chaos and everything else, your home is a combat zone. And it's not that it's actually literally people shooting at each other, which in some places it might be. But, you know, the way that your mind processes it because of the chaos, because of the disarray, I guess. Your mind processes it into, you're still overseas, you're still downrange, and you shouldn't feel like you're on that two-way shooting range once you're home and once you're back, you know.
Yeah.
I've got to give credit to my mother. Whenever I came back from the Marine Corps, our house, her house, where I stayed, was always relaxed, calm, you know.
Feng shui.
Yeah. You know, it was one of those things you always, you know, I got to the point where I didn't want to go anywhere because I was just that relaxed. You know. And yeah, I became a homebody. You know, and don't get me wrong, I like to go and do stuff, but I there for a little while, I got to a point that I just wanted to stay in a house. I didn't feel like I needed to go and do anything. Now, getting into Stan Moore, what he said, being afraid to walk out of your own house. I know a lot of people that are like that. I know a lot of vets that have gotten to that point. And there's a lot of reasons for it. And Stan, I don't want you to air out your laundry on the show or anything. And if you want to talk to us, please feel free. Shoot us an email, you know, or shoot me a message on Facebook, and I'll talk to you. I've heard of several vets becoming shut-ins because of their anxiety and everything like that. What that comes down to is you've got to get yourself, and I don't want to make it sound bad, but you need to go get some help. You need to go get an outlet. You know, you need to talk to the people that are there to help you. And, you know, I'm not a psychologist. I'm not a psychiatrist. I'm not a counselor. I'm nothing. I'm just another vet that's trying to help other vets. But the big one, the big thing for me is you. That's
got
two.
It. Got it.
That's two.
Piece of crap.
That's two. Mm-hmm. But anyway, so the big thing is get to, you know, and if you don't want to go to the VA, go to the vet center. Find out if there's a vet center in your area. Okay. If there is, here's the thing. The vet center will help you. And a lot of times the counselors at the vet center are veterans themselves. So that in and of itself can help. Because a lot of people don't want to talk to some college-educated retard that doesn't know what we've been through. Okay.
Or they assume everybody, they got a degree on a wall. They throw it in your face, they're smarter than you are. And they want a job, so they say, look, you're messed up.
Right.
Or she's messed up. Or I'm messed up. That's just a diagnosis for everybody.
Right.
When in reality, people are just different.
Right.
You know,
and everybody processes everything different. And that's one thing that you need to be mindful of. We all have issues.
Right.
Okay. Some of us have more issues. Well, some of us have more issues than Time Magazine. And we all process those issues differently. You know, you're going to look at a situation like I was a couple weeks ago, and you're going to be like, no big deal. You know, or you're going to hit it head on and you're just going to be like, okay, you know, and boom, 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 boom. And you've got everything laid out and ready to go. And you're working through the different steps that you need to work through. Whereas me, I look at the big picture and I go, oh my God, how am I going to get through this? And I don't pay attention to the smaller frame of, okay, I've got this to do. But I need to figure out what steps I need to take to get from point A to point B. I just try and hit it head on and take everything at once.
Right.
You know, so it's kind of one of those things where, and they'll help you learn those coping skills and those dealing, you know, those management skills, to get through whatever anxiety issue you're getting through, you know, you're working on. The other side of it is if you are at that point, they're not going to try and admit you unless you're a danger to yourself or somebody else.
Right.
Okay. You know, so go out, reach out, find the help. Okay. Find the right avenue for you. And I understand, Stan. He says, I've dealt with this since 1985 until I couldn't work anymore. It's a long-term thing. I'll let me put it this way to you, Stan. Okay. You need to see somebody, okay? And I'm not saying that you're messed up or anything like that. You need to talk to somebody about it, okay? You need to get out there and this is my message directly to you. You need to go for it.
Thank you for tuning in, Stan.
Yeah, this actually helps us.
And we're glad that you're here to watch. You know, you heard Justin and I talk about a number 35, and we heard a lot. And last night, that got brought up a lot. And I've seen tears in people's eyes. Mm-hmm. They didn't realize that number grew that high already. And we're glad you're not one of the numbers. But listen to us when we tell you this. Both of us have suffered, but we suffered different ways. Okay? Justin, he was about to be one of those numbers. Okay?
Yep.
That's how he suffered. I suffered the other way. I was making people want to be one of those numbers. Okay? I just beat people up just because I could, okay. And we, both of us, have walked the same exact, had a different ending, okay. But we were walking the exact same path. I don't like a lot of people either. I like to be either outside or be up on stage where I can see what's going on. I went and got help. But I surrounded myself with people who had my best interest at heart.
Right.
Okay. I got friends that are hard men. We fish, we fight, we do anything, but we all have the same things in common. We love each other and want to help each other survive. We see right. some. We see somebody. We might be big tough men, but we see somebody needing help. I'm not afraid to reach in my pocket and give it 20. Mm-hmm. You know, give it 10. Surround yourself. It starts with your family. Your family is the biggest family. When you build a house, you don't build it from roof down. You build it from the foundation up.
Right.
And that's what we need to do. We need to get you a solid foundation. Okay.
Right.
It starts right here.
Right.
It starts with people looking in you. When the guy looks in your mirror every day, that's you. Your family. They get on board with you. It's a step. And I'm going to tell you something. And I'm going to say this. It might get a lot of frowns. It's not going to be easy.
No.
Every day is a constant struggle.
Oh, yeah. It's a fight.
It's a constant struggle for me not to beat the shit out of somebody. It's a constant struggle for him not to beat the crap out of somebody. It's a constant struggle for us to be so cheerfully and glee and loud and handsome that we've heard
well, today. Well, and here's something else. And this woman back here, okay, that's been in my life for 35 years now.
By the way, she told me she adopted you.
Yeah. Well, she adopted me 35 years ago. Okay, I'll do that right now, Stan. But you know the crap, it won't let me.
Yeah, something wrong
with the... Yeah, there's something going on with Facebook right now. It's being a jerk. But anyway, I'll make sure I look you up after the show, Stan. And
you know something, Stan? We got any more of those Richard Rogers books?
I think so. Yeah, I'll have to go up and look.
He'd be a great candidate for one of those.
Now, the thing that, you know, this woman back here, and I could get her on the mic, and she could attest to watching me go on this roller coaster. You know, when I'm high, you know, my highs are as high as they can get. My lows are as low as they can get. You know, and it's just this roller coaster ride. And it's how it is. I mean, you know, there's days where I'm on cloud nine, I'm freaking rocking and rolling, I'm having fun, I'm doing great. And the very next day, I'm down in the dumps and I wish
it could be by the end of the day.
Yeah. It's
put somebody through a table.
Right. And it's not an easy walk.
No.
It never will be.
That's the burden and the sacrifice that we took upon ourselves. I'm not asking for any sympathy.
Right.
To defend it, to defend our country, do what
right.
we do. And I'll walk that, and I don't mind walking it. But
exactly,
I want to walk a lot of people with me.
Stan just said, just numb. Good morning, Jerry. Gary. Jerry.
Morning,
I don't
want
to fucking name up, but I did.
Stan.
Ian Stills watching, so what's up, Ian?
You get numb, buddy. I mean, that's just one of the emotions. I get angry. I don't as much anymore. I've really tried to. You know, I used to assault cops all the time. Really, I did. They wouldn't wave at me. I'd jerk them out of a cop car.
Yeah.
I've really had to find out the root of my problem. And the root of my problem? Life.
Right.
How I was handling life. Mm-hmm. You know, guys, we don't want that number 35 getting any higher. Stan,
no.
Brother, listen. I'm on. Not only this show here help you out, but I'm going to do a little shameless plug. Okay? I'm on YouTube. I got my own website. You want to laugh, talk, and to other people, not just veterans, but other people, get on one of my sites. We'll talk with you anytime. Make you laugh. Tell you something witty. Tell you something stupid. We don't care. You know, if you're laughing, you ain't crying.
Right. And we do a lot of stupid stuff on the show here. You know, and we tell a lot of jokes. We screw with the other shows, whatever.
Yeah.
And Stan, that reply is to you, okay? That is my personal cell phone number. If you need to talk, text me, okay? A lot of times I don't have my phone on me, so...
Don't let him lie. He got on him. He sleeps a lot.
Well, no, not even that. It's, you know, if I'm working, I normally don't have my phone actually dead on me. It's over, you know, wherever. But shoot me a tech. What is up? Oh, so we've got Ian and the entire counterfeit crew checking in right there. So what's up, G Tech?
I can't wait to meet that guy.
And the rest of, what, Ian and Jesse and the crew?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're great guys. They're phenomenal.
Listen, this is gonna be it's counting down,
yeah.
My friend.
Oh yeah, right. We're down
today
to
today is September.
Yep. We are. It's on.
You know, Kyiv, Europe. It's the final countdown. It's the countdown to the biggest extravaganza.
This side of the Mississippi.
This side of anywhere. Okay.
Right. Yeah.
We've got folks coming from both sides of the continent.
Uh-huh.
I'm just saying. Yep. I'm just saying. It's like the Missouri boys.
Dropping the ball on us.
Hmm.
But anyway, so
but Stan, come if you can come out. I don't know where you're from, Stan, and I don't know your financial situation. But if you got an opportunity to come November 9th and 10th to Kansas City Warrior Fest,
if you can make it out here, Stan, I will get you in for free. Okay, it will be on me. All right, I will pay for both of your days. If you can get out here and find a place to stay, I will pay for both of your days to get in here and hang out with some vets and just, you know, we'll surround you with the love that is the Brotherhood. Okay, and I know Ian and the gang at Counterfeit will definitely, you know, welcome you with open arms. Blackie and Maximus, you know, all of the guys, they will definitely. North Alabama. Okay,
Stan, I'm making enough. I'll tell you my Bell palsy story.
Oh God.
How
I wish I could get into the Comedy Vets office and get palsy the Bell.
Dude, we got to bring it. Somehow that's got to make the trip.
That's going to have to make the trip down to Kansas City.
The joke behind that, guys, I was telling the story about how I got Bell palsy, how I discovered I had it, right? And these derelicts back there had a bell back there, and we had a timer on it. So when you get close to your timer, you ding, ding the bell, right? So I took a Sharpie at the end of the day and I wrote bells on it. I wrote palsy on it, so it's Bell's palsy. And now the little thing's got a smiley face and it's red. Man, it's hilarious. It's just an inside joke. But Sam, brother, come on, we'll make you laugh. You know, I've been there as far as the numb goes. You know, I don't know what it's called. I had a symptom. Sometimes I just sit and I just stare. It feels like I'm just floating. You know, any of y'all ever had that? You're floating. You don't want to talk. You want to watch something, but you don't want to watch it. You know, you want to drink, but you don't want to drink. You're just there. 2-3 hours go by. Another 2 or 3 hours go by. You know, pretty soon, the day's gone. You need nothing. But don't be trapped in your house, man. I was glad that you said that because I had a conversation with a gentleman who, 20 years, he stayed in his house. He didn't even know his own neighborhood. He got back from the service, he stayed in his house, didn't know his own neighborhood. He didn't know he had an Arby's. He loved Arby's. Arby's is fresh, his favorite sandwiches, right? He didn't even know they had one right just 2 blocks down the road because he didn't know his neighborhood no more. Didn't even know it was there. Been there 10 years. Didn't know it. Now he gets out. He comes to shows. He goes things. He don't go a lot of places. He picks his 5 little spots, and that's where he goes.
Right.
So I encourage you, get out of your house, man. Don't lock yourself up because what's that old saying? The idle time is the devil's hand or something like that?
Idle hands are the devil's tool.
Yeah. Don't.
Well, and okay. Sorry, I just bumped my mic. Stan just said he was a musician. And here's the thing, okay?
Well, you're not kind of the same. I'm a comedian.
I'm a musician as well.
Yeah.
I don't play anymore because I got tired of the grind, but that's a big outlet. That is a huge, a huge
you're physically broken down
release.
Sam. So am I, brother.
We all are.
I want you to understand something. You're not the only guy that's walked that path.
Right.
And that's
and
why
we've
you're
all
not,
dealt with it.
And you're not going to be the only guy doing it alone.
Right.
You're not going to walk alone. We're here for you.
You know, I mean, make sure you copy my number down. You've got my number, okay? That is the biggest thing I can tell you right now. Reach out. If you get to where you're feeling depressed, you're feeling numb, you're feeling down and out, reach out to somebody. If you just need to vent, I'll put my phone on speaker, mute my microphone, and let you scream at me for freaking 45 minutes if I have to.
Yeah.
You know, I don't care. If it keeps you from doing something stupid, I'm going to, be there for it.
Right, and you can reach out to whoever's on here watching right now.
I guarantee anybody who is watching this show right now.
Help this man out. Give this guy kind word.
Yeah. Sorry, my throat's getting dry. I've been dealing with sinuses all week, and my throat keeps getting dry on me. You know, with that being said, you know,
and I know it seems like there's no help out there, quality help.
Well, there is.
Things take time, and I know people don't want to hear it because this is, we're a society that
there's a saying in Alcoholics Anonymous, time takes time. And it's what it's saying and what that means. And I'm not trying to sound all philosophical or whatever. Shut up, computer.
I mean, it's horrible, and it didn't do that before.
I missed his post. He says it's from North Alabama.
Yeah,
well, first of all, what a beautiful state.
Yeah, it's just gorgeous out there.
No, we're getting it. Well, we're trying to come down around that way. Comedy Vets. Keep a lookout for Comedy Vets. We're trying to come down around that way. And if you see me out there, man, come to me. I'll talk to you, visit with you. You know, shake your hand.
You know, and honestly, ultimately, we want to take the show on the road too, down the road. You know, but you know, when it comes down to it, you know, obviously, you know, with being vets, you know, they always say if you got messed up head, bad knees, bad back, bad shoulders, you're probably a vet. Something like that. Yeah, you know, we are. And thank you, Ian, for your kind words there, but Ian's a great friend.
Friend of the show. He's always commenting on there.
Yeah, Ian
likes me better though.
Oh yeah, yeah, definitely. even though he's never met you,
not a clue who I am.
So yeah, you know, Stan lives less than a mile from the Tennessee River. Go fishing.
Sweet.
You know, fishing is not a physically taxing.
No, wouldn't be doing it.
You know, yeah, I wouldn't.
I mean, come on.
You know, the hardest I've ever fished was actually offshore.
Yeah, but that's some nice fishing.
Oh God, it was fun, and I miss it. If I could ever get back out to the coast and go offshore fishing again, I would in a heartbeat. But anyway, the you know, and that's the thing, you know. Our organization, our parent organization of the show is Warrior Outdoors. It doesn't have to be outdoor stuff to relax and to recover.
No,
you know,
no, they say that's the best thing to get them out because the sun,
right.
You get vitamin 12 and all that stuff. But yeah, I know where you're going.
Vitamin 12.
Yeah. B12, vitamin 12, D12, 100 C. Dude, I ain't a scientist.
I don't know. Anyway, so,
the photosynthesis, that's what it is.
Sure, something like that. osmosis or something. I don't know. I think that's how I tried to learn through school was osmosis. I always slept on my books. I thought I'd just absorb it.
I had reverse osmosis.
Drooling on your books?
Cockroaches.
But anyway, you know, there's so much that we can do, okay, as far as trying to find a way to recover, trying to find something that just gives you a chance to not have to focus on the bad shit.
Right. I think being in a hurry is one of the worst things you can do.
That, yeah.
Time and patience and consistency.
Mm-hmm.
Continue doing your treatments. Continue doing your exercises. If you don't want to go see a psychiatrist, that's fine. If you've got some other culture like mine who got other ways to do it, do it. But it consistently.
If you are one of those people who goes to church religiously, and I mean every Sunday, Wednesday, whatever, go. But go and talk to your preacher as well. Go talk to your pastor. Go talk to your pastor.
Whatever
the
pecking order is.
Yeah. They can help. They are trained to deal with situations like this. They're trained. And, okay, yeah, they may not have the legit 100% answer.
Who does?
For whatever you're dealing with at that current moment, but they might have something to help get to that 100% answer, and they might work with you to develop a 100% answer. But it's going to take time. You've got to remember you can't get in a hurry. Rome wasn't built in a day, and nobody heals from anything in a day. You broke your arm 2 weeks ago?
Three.
3 weeks ago. Is it healed yet?
No.
Is it healed now?
No.
How about now?
Nope.
Okay.
Wait a minute. No.
No. Okay. So you see what I'm saying?
But it's, is it going to?
Yes. Yeah.
It's what just I gotta have
time.
Time and patience.
Know? It's like whenever I broke my middle finger. You know, I walked around like this for 4 weeks, for 4.5 weeks before I could actually bend it again.
Yeah.
And you know, and the doctor even said, I don't know how you didn't sever your finger with the way I broke it. Mm-hmm. But you know, so it and you know how much of a pain in the ass it was to drive a big dump truck with that finger stuck out like that?
Yeah, but to counter that, I bet you had a lot of fun waving at people. Hey!
No, I didn't wave very much, but it looked like I was flipping everybody off because I like to drive with my hand up like this on the window and stuff. Yeah. So I'm sitting there like this all the time.
Oh, hey, by the way, I want to plug something. I got a ladder for sale. Anybody wants to buy a ladder? It's only hurt one person.
Yeah, it's only hurt one person, huh? So ladder with no juju, with bad juju.
Yeah, I gotta get my feather out though, and kind of, I gotta bless it because
burn some sage on it or something.
And you know something about that? The day this happened, I fought that ladder all day. It didn't want to be hauled. It kept coming loose from the rack, which I had it tied to.
Okay, that should have told you something right there. Like, well, I'm not all the, you know, new agey and spiritual and stuff like that, but I do believe in karma, and I do believe in bad omens. Uh-huh. And if something's just not cooperating, you probably shouldn't deal with it.
Uh-huh. And the sad thing is, before I went up to the last rung I was on, right, something said, don't go no higher. I said, I've been doing this for 25 years. I'm just going to hit that one little spot because I didn't want to move the ladder because I was lazy. I went up that rung. Reached out there, ladder went this way, I spun went this way. Next thing I know, I slam, bang, face planted. Ladder was over going.
Yeah,
quietly.
Got you, bitch.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, you're for sale, punk. I'll take food stamps. don't let somebody drop an EBT card. You got a new home. I ain't playing. I mean, I'm redneck. Don't play me. Oh, a jug of tea and a food stamp card.
There you go.
Ladder traded.
So there you go. $10 in food stamps and a jug of tea, and you can have a new ladder. But
and I guarantee you, it'll whip your ass.
Yeah. So
it's a millennial ladder. Don't want to work.
I like that one. That was a good one. Oh man,
Stan, that was to help you make you laugh a little bit.
There you go. You need to post that on one of the swap shops. Millennial ladder, it doesn't want to work.
and is a pain.
Yeah, it's a pain in the ass. But
pain in the arm.
Well, that too.
I don't know.
Well, see, if you would have landed on your ass, you wouldn't have gotten hurt.
Yes, I would. I got an ass of a 6-year-old boy. I ain't got no ass. I'd have died. I'd have vertebrae problems. Shit. You know what hurt worse, though? The bruised rib and bruised sternum hurt worse than the arm.
Yeah.
Because every time I fart, sneeze, burp, or try to wipe my ass.
Yeah, because you're... Yeah.
Well, it's like, take more pain meds. I'm already higher than Georgia Pine.
Right.
Okay, half the time I think of pooping, I ain't pooping.
You're probably as higher than Keith Richards at one point. She's telling you to get higher.
I mean, Biscuit, he says, I'm the madhouse now. Who are you? I've been living with you for a while. I don't know you. The hell?
Oh, man.
Of course, I don't know if I was high when I was talking about it. I think I was making that shit up because I don't know him. But yeah.
Well, you know.
But, yeah, but we appreciate – hey, listen, we appreciate all y'all. Where are we at on shares? Anyway, we ain't even keeping track of that.
I haven't even really paid attention to it today. I'm just – yeah, you're going to break something.
Yeah, we ain't gonna
do it so so
but we haven't given a shirt away in a while. We'd like to give one of them shirts away to somebody, to a good listener. You know, I'll tell you what, Stan –
let's give him a shirt.
Yeah, we're going to sweeten it a little bit more for you, Stan.
Okay.
We'll throw in one of these nice shirts right here if you give us a size. And I'm going to throw in personally some Comedy Vets merch.
Okay.
You know that little box I got upstairs?
Yeah.
That stands.
Okay.
It's got a shot glass in it. Mm-hmm. It's got a dog tag.
Yeah, it's got one. The shot glass is really cool, too. It's one of the little mini mason jar shot glasses. I want one really bad. 4X.
Well, we don't have one that big.
Don't have that one. I can show two X's together.
Yeah, give mom something to do.
Yeah,
get her sewing machine. Yeah. But anyway, you got a shot glass. Looks like
we'll
a mason jar, but the shot
we'll
glass.
Get you something.
You got a bracelet in there. Yeah. Dog tag. I think I give a dog tag and a necklace bowl.
Yep.
Just tell me what your favorite color is, and we'll hook that up for you. We'll send you a shirt anyway. You can hook it. You can hang it somewheres and enjoy our show when we watch our show with it.
Yeah. Or if you got a grandkid and you just want to give it to them, you know.
We'll do that for you. And I'll tell you what I do, Stan. You get yourself to the show, and we'll get you a ticket for free. You get in for free.
Favorite color is blue.
We already offered
it
to you.
Didn't have a way to get up here, but
anytime, and that's a standing offer to you, Stan. Whenever you see us, and we're out somewhere.
Yeah,
just you.
Anywhere
VIP,
we are, if we're in
you
your
just
area.
Come hang with us.
Yeah, if we're in your area,
and I'll notify security wherever I'm at during one of my shows. If we're somewhere, you just tell them we're with us. You're our VIP. You're with us, dude.
There you go.
And
very
that's
important.
For you, Stan. And we'll throw in Richard Rogers. Fishers of Men book.
Fishers of Trout and Men.
Fishers of Trout
book.
Men. I keep leaving the trout out.
Yeah,
Fishers of Trout and Men. It's a poetry book.
But it's good. It'll give you a lot to think about, and it'll actually, you know, I've been diving into it a little bit lately.
I figured you'd be hitting it for long.
You know, again.
It's like Tennessee whiskey.
Oh, yeah.
Chris Stapleton.
You know, but, you know, so he said his favorite color is blue. So, you know, and we'll you know, we want to help you guys out. We want to be there for our fans and the people who interact with us on a weekly basis and everything. You know, and so it's kind of one of those things like, oh, we're going to have a nationally touring rock band sending us a picture.
Oh yeah.
And it's guess what they're going to be wearing?
Metallica finally got wise and
no.
Oh. Bosipas?
No. Flaw.
Okay, well, that's good.
They're going to be sending us a picture of them in Woe Radio Show shirts.
Oh, they're going to say, swear to God, I was going to say they weren't naked.
No.
Just wearing a shirt.
No. So. No, they're wearing shirts.
Cool.
So,
sweet.
Nice. I just got to deliver those to them Tuesday. So I'll be running up to St. Joe to meet them. On a scale of shrub to Georgia pine, how high is Richie this week? I think he's about a shrub right now.
I'm about a shrub. I'm coming out. I haven't took any of this stuff. I don't like painkillers anyway.
Yeah.
So I've come down on. But
that was from the bar.
I still got a little bit, though, now.
Yeah.
I ain't totally.
Yeah. Well, if it gets really, really bad, take one or whatever. Something like that.
Now I take it and leave now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. But so far, I've been doing pretty well.
You know, go ahead.
The next show.
Go ahead.
Is September 11th at the Scene in Kansas City.
Right.
We're going to have a band, Damien Gunn Band, there.
Yeah.
And anybody else that wants to be a part of it, get a hold of Jeff Onyx. Dude, this thing's going to be patriotic as heck. People talk about last night. They already want to come. Guys, there's jokes.
Where's that
told.
At?
It's a Scene in Kansas City.
The Scene, okay.
Yeah. It's Rock Bar, I believe. I think it's what they. It's an
I think
old rock
so.
Bar.
Yeah. Because I think Head PE just played there.
If Flaw wants to come, Maximus come ahead of time. See what they're getting into. See the kind of shenanigans that they're going to be affiliated with.
All right,
hey, take care.
See you later on.
Hey, go ahead and get some sandwiches for us, will you?
Huh?
You make us some sandwiches.
Yeah, okay.
I don't want sandwiches.
Don't forget to lock up. Bring my keys.
So hit us upside the head of that purse.
But
come on out there and have a good
time.
Yeah,
that purse weighs a ton.
Because this is now, we got a lot of busy things coming up. The show does, Comedy Vets
right.
do. September, October, November, until Warrior Fest, man. It's just, September 1st today, Warrior Fest, I'm getting pumped.
Yeah.
I'm starting to hear Rocky in my head.
I'm super excited. I'm actually trying
boom,
to.
Boom, 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 boom. I'm starting to hear Rocky in my head. Yeah.
I'm trying to stay as subdued as possible.
Why?
Just because it's my nature, but
I'm
super stoked for Warrior Fest. I'm super stoked for the guys to come out. And
I can't wait for that check you're gonna pay me though. That's
it's in the mail. apparently my check's in the mail too. So
you know, they mailed them together. I guess.
So
that one from VRS Bounce, by the way.
I don't know.
We had BV and BV Nation's money, or the bar's money.
Right.
I mean, they go live from a freaking bar every week.
Right.
Know, drunk asses.
Yeah.
Bunch of losses.
So, no. Make sure you check out the other shows on the network here. We've got, I'm just going to go ahead and pull up the list so I don't screw anything up.
And we don't hurt anybody's feelings or forget about our brothers. Well, I got a shock a while ago. I had to drive the wife's Jeep, okay, because somebody looks like me can't put gas in his freaking truck, okay, because, well, you know, when you're out of your mind, you don't think about things like that.
You're always out of
your
mind.
So I turned this on. I figured my wife had some decent quality music playing. Okay. I turned up, you ready?
You got jokes.
And all I heard was, hello. What the hell is. And I had it turned up, boy. I was getting ready to thump it. It was Adele. Now, understand something. Adele can sing, okay?
Yeah, sure.
I'm just not an Adele fan.
All right. Okay, so.
I had to give my man card back.
On Sunday nights, you've got the Bear News, and then you've got BV Nation. Our buddies over at BV Nation. Back the Bear News has.
Reading Your Sister Nation, yeah.
Yeah. What? I said we weren't throwing shots at him this week.
Oh, I didn't get that memo.
But anyway.
I get a pass. I'm high.
So
I love them.
Let's see. I'm losing my spot here. Saturdays you've got us, and then you've got 1700 somewhere. The other technical difficulty show. Why do they have both shows that have the most technical difficulties on the same day?
I got an answer for that. I figured out why. Because it's Saturday, more people are on the internet on Saturdays than any other day of the week.
I guess. And then let's see on. Wednesdays, you've got the BRS Bar and Short Timer Radio. You've also got Warrior Wallet on Thursday nights. You've got Reality Check on Friday nights. And I'm trying to think.
Now, are all our brothers and sisters over here pumping out Warrior Fest for us, too?
Some are, some are not. I can't really say who is and who isn't because...
Well, we know for a fact the Bar is, and thank you. And we know our brothers from BV Nation, thank you, are doing it.
Of course.
I think Judy's mentioned this a time or two when she's been on here messing around.
Right. And so, you know, and you know, no matter who it is on the show and pimping stuff out or whatever, you know, we love everybody on the network here.
Absolutely, not a doubt. We like to play back and forth because sometimes it kills the monotony.
Oh, yeah. And that's just something we do.
Veterans have always did it. We picked on Army, Navy. Yeah. We picked on them all. Right. When it comes together, put a weapon in our hand for this country, we're all back to back united, and we will kick somebody's ass if they mess with one of our brothers.
Right. Yeah, definitely. And then, you know, and honestly, Judy is... there we go. I got it. Cool. So here's the great part about the veteran family, okay? And I don't even want to say brotherhood because it sounds like we're not including everybody else. Stan, I got your address. Thank you. Judy is going to be at Warrior Fest, okay? And Judy is going to be doing the roast. She's going to be the roast master for us.
Oh, they're going to roast us, huh?
Yeah. So, and I specifically, because if anybody has seen the roast of BV Nation, where Judy went first, Judy left BV Nation a steaming pile of mush. So nobody else could get at them. I mean, there was nothing else you could say after Judy got a hold of them. And it was like Judy to me is the next Lisa Lampanelli. Mm-hmm. You know, she's supposed to be getting on stage and doing a stand-up set too.
Just to understand, when you come into Big Dog's yard,
Big
Dog does bite.
I know. She's all right.
I hope they'll roast the shit out of me because remember, we get a turn too.
I know. So, you know.
Awesome. That's going to be sweet, though. I'm going to have fun doing that.
Oh, yeah. It'll be a blast. It'll be...
BV Nation owe us an explanation of why they're not bringing their mobile unit.
Yeah. I would like to know why they can't bring it, but it is what it is. Who cares? We'll figure it out. So I'm trying to pull the comments back up so I know I'm not missing anything. It's the computer screen sits quite a ways away from us, so it's kind of hard to read them.
Yeah, no kidding.
And through the shades, I definitely can't read it that well.
Well, the reason I got my sunglasses on, I want to be able to see things.
Right.
I've been so messed up for weeks. I'm glad to
see
shit.
Double of everything.
Oh man, colors are I mean, when I was out there,
I can smell colors.
I was in shock so bad that I seen the grass grow from green. Grass went pink. Everything went white. All I could hear was voices. Okay.
You were high as hell.
No. This was when after I fell. I got up.
Oh,
my body was in shock like that.
Yeah.
And then when it had me so high, colors were weird. I'm thinking, finally, I love you, white. I miss you, white. Black.
Yeah.
Woo,
green and orange and
I was in a stand looking at my wardrobe like, so,
whoa,
where'd all my sleeves go? Oh yeah, no shit.
I'm surprised you ain't cut the sleeves off your shirt yet.
Well, I was gonna, but they got our sponsors on there, so I'm kind
of. Well, you've got two of them.
I might cut one sleeve off, leave one. Be like a gay redneck. Hey, no.
Do I need to mute you?
Somebody probably should a long time ago.
So, but anyway, so.
But Stan, like we're saying, so this is what we do. We get all point and get back on.
Yeah, right.
Brother, thank you for not being one of the numbers.
Okay? Right. And reaching out, thank man. You for reaching out. Like and, that right there is why we do what we do.
Exactly our friend
Christine just joined on.
That's exactly why. And if you're on here right now and you know Stan or don't know Stan, get to know him.
Yeah, shoot him a, you know what?
Friend request.
I want everybody right now to blow up Stan's inbox with positive, okay? And
positive,
and Stan, I'm going to apologize right now because
ahead of
I'm
time.
Doing this. However,
yes,
everybody on the show, everybody that sees this show, head over, shoot Stan a positive message, okay? Shoot everybody else you see on here a positive message. Here's the thing, okay? And my Aunt Belinda just joined in. Here's the thing about what we're trying to do here at the WoW Radio Show, okay? We want, more than anything, okay, we want that positiveness, that just, and not to sound all fruity and whatever, but we want to surround every veteran, everybody who's dealing with the same stuff that we're dealing with, veteran or not, surround them with love. Surround them with positive thoughts. Surround them with just overwhelming sense of just community. Okay, it you know the saying goes you know it takes a community you know it takes a village. Well, it does, and it takes a village to take care of a village. Okay, and I'm not even going to say one person. You know, it takes a village to raise a child. It takes a village to take care of somebody who's hurting. And right now, the veteran village needs to rally around Stan. The veteran village, you know, the American village needs to rally around those people who need it, who need us to be a listening ear, who need us to just make them laugh.
You know, one of the main things for homelessness, you guys were talking about this last week, and yeah. I was in and out of consciousness, so I didn't get to put it down there.
Right.
But a lot of times people are, you know why a lot of veterans are homeless?
Pride.
They want to be. It's a simple fact. Pride. They want to be.
Well, it's not even that they want to be. They don't want to go asking.
Money's number two.
Right.
But the first thing, pride.
They
want
to
be. They don't want to ask for help. Right. They don't. They want to be alone. They want to be
right.
out there.
Right.
And which? Of the among the leading suicide are homeless.
Mm-hmm.
Loan is good to a point, but it's not the way to be, guys. That's when things happen. When you're alone, your mind can be your best weapon or your worst weapon. It really can. And you don't need to be alone. Sometimes alone is great if you want to take a nap or you know you and your woman some quality time. But when you're thinking about things that's not adding up. And I'm not trying to say specific words for a reason, but if you're thinking about things that are not adding up in your head, you don't need to be alone. You need to get that out. You need
right,
to talk
yeah.
to other people.
Definitely.
Don't be afraid, man.
Definitely.
The first step is that foot that you put forward. Then the next one. After you step first, guys, what you've already did the hard part. You already took the first step. Take another one.
Right.
Take another one. Pretty soon.
And real quick, I've got to tell Aunt Belinda, I love you too. Aunt Belinda's been a big help to me. For many years.
Don't know her.
And, well, she doesn't live here in town. She lives where I grew up. But she's always been there for me. She's always been one of those people that's been kind of the voice of reason.
Good family foundation.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, and so the big thing is, okay, Stan, I'll as soon as we get off the air, I'll go over and check him out. The big thing is, and just like what I just said with Aunt Belinda, you develop that foundation, okay? You develop that base, okay?
The word you've heard a lot in the military, camaraderie.
Camaraderie, exactly. You know, you start with your close-knit family group, okay? You know, Richie's in my central circle. Surprisingly, but he is, okay?
But I got a question mark on me. Or no, was that an asterisk?
Asterisks. Yeah. You got an asterisk.
But I'm there.
But I also know that if I need to, if I need to vent, if I need help with something, I mean, I can call Richie. You know, I've got a project with this new house. Okay. Perfect example. Okay. This isn't anything serious or nothing, but here's a perfect example. Okay. I got told that I've got this house, right?
Mm-hmm. Which is a blessing to you.
The first thing I did was called Richie and I said, hey, I don't know a whole lot about this. I think I know what I'm getting into, but I want to see if you would come over to the house with me and tell me what I need to do to fix the plumbing, because they winterized it before they moved out. The house has been vacant for a year and a half.
Yeah.
So Ty Richeson, I served with that guy. Oh, cool. So he's he just joined in. So, you know, it comes down to, you know, it doesn't matter how minuscule and finite it is. You know, if I'm having a rough day and I just need to vent, I can call Richie and he'll probably tell me to quit being a big baby. But on the same note, if I just need to get the shit out of my head, he'll do it. He'll listen, you know. If I just want to go out and sit in the freaking woods, he'll come and get me if I don't feel like driving, I bet. You know, it's one of those things that you've got to surround yourself with a positive base. And I said this last week, mm-hmm. I'm not talking about people who are going to tell you yes to everything.
Oh, guys, it's you don't need robots.
No, you don't need yes men. You need people.
That is what's wrong. People get confused at what Justin's saying. That's the wrong way. That robot crap. I mean, I've had a lot of yes men because people are scared of me, and they go say something else behind my back. I don't want that.
Right.
I want people to say, "Look, I understand what you're saying. Mm-hmm. I don't agree with what you're doing."
Right.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Cool.
I trust. You know what? I'll go to combat with that dude.
Yeah.
Because I trust that guy.
Exactly.
And yeah. You don't trust that guy because he's trying to hone in and do something he shouldn't be doing anyway.
He's trying to weasel his way.
Make sure you understand with Justin. He made a hell of a point. We don't need robots. We need people who ain't afraid to tell you yeah, but at the same time tell you no, but at the same time tell you, hey, man, good job. Good job, Justin, on creating Warrior Fest, man, and getting this all lined out. You did a hell of a job. How can I assist you, sir? Right. Something like that. Hey, man, you did a good job. Hey, man, what's in it for me? What's in it for me? Oh. Okay. You see, no freaking robots.
Right. And, there you go. Right there. Perfect. You see what Belinda Snodgrass just said? Belinda Snodgrass Ashley, my Aunt Belinda. She said, yes, sometimes I'm blunt, but I say it like it is. Exactly. And that's what you've got to surround yourself
with. Her delivery. It's her delivery.
I won't lie. I've gotten mad at her because of the way she's put stuff. But in time, I got the hell over myself, mm-hmm. and I said, you know what? That makes perfect sense. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah, it took me some time because I'm a bonehead, and I will admit I'm a bonehead. And I, you know, and yeah, if Richie tells me something and he says it in a way that just kind of rubs me wrong or whatever, yeah, I'm probably going to get mad at him. And you might not see him on the show for a couple of weeks. But once I take the time to think about it, I'm going to go, huh, okay.
That fat mother.
You know,
let me call him.
You know, and then I'm also going to sit there and go, God damn it, I miss him. You know, and it's one of those things where you've got to surround yourself with people that are going to be blunt, who are going to be honest, who are going to tell you how it is.
That's very important.
You know, because I was waiting, and I've been waiting for somebody to, you know, and it's kind of funny because. whenever I was talking about possibly building the studio in the basement of the new house,
right,
I was talking to J-Dub.
Right.
And he called it the murder room. What he didn't realize, well, what he didn't realize is the reason I'm building it the way that I want to build it is because I've got two toddlers. Okay, I've got two boys. So, you know, it's either A, I've got to build it this way to where there is no sound making it down from upstairs or anything like that, or otherwise you're going to hear all the damn time, and you're not going to be able to understand a word we're saying because all you're going to hear is, you know. So with that being said, guys, you know, I'm never, you know, and I will never look at somebody and tell them that their idea is a shit idea if it's, you know, not a great idea. But
it might not be the right idea at that time.
Right.
And what I'll do is come back in later and be a good idea.
And I typically, I analyze everything. Okay. And a lot of times I overanalyze everything. And I will admit that. But what I'll do is I'll say, okay, you know, what if you approach it from this route? Okay. You know, I look at the big picture and I normally don't look at the small steps that I need to get from A to B. A lot of us do that. Okay. And if you can't admit to yourself that you do that, then you need to take a step back. Okay. Here's why. If I'm trying to, okay, we'll just use the studio example. Okay. I'm trying to build a new studio for the show, right? Well, I'm going to need a whole bunch of stuff, but I haven't thought about what I'm going to need to do this. You know, I'm going to have to frame walls. I'm going to have to put drywall up. I'm going to have to put foam, you know, soundproofing up. I'm going to have to do a lot of different things. Insulation, outlets, plugs, you know, light switches, lighting, you know, all kinds of, you know, fans, because it's probably going to get hot in there or cold in there, whatever, you know. So
because one of us is overweight and takes up a lot of heat.
Well, you know.
Produces a lot of heat.
Well, that'll be great in the wintertime. Because I'll just sit closer to you. But, but
Brokeback Mountain Studio.
The Brokeback Radio Show. But anyway, so, but, you know, and so I've got to be cognizant. Look at that big word for this dumb redneck over here.
I'm trying to ask, what do you say? Cognizant.
Yeah. You know, I have to be conscious of what steps I've got to take. I've got to be conscious of the materials that I'm going to need. I've got to be conscious of the space that I have, you know. And so all of these different things I've got to work towards.
Right.
And, you know, we're going to have to, you know, we're working on raising money to upgrade our computer. We're working on raising money to upgrade our equipment. You know, what I'm ultimately going to do is this board that we have now is going to be our remote board. And then we're going to have a permanent board that stays in the studio. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So it's all in time. And I know it's going to take a few months. You know, I know it's not going to happen overnight. I want it to, because I want to keep going with what we've got going on. You know, I love what I have here at the show. I love the fact that you guys let me do this every week. I love the fact that we've got, you know, people who will directly interact with us and say, hey, you know, I'm having an issue, you know, and boom. And, you know, I picked the topic today about having a recovery, and Stan messaged us, or, you know, text, you know, commented, you know, and having that recovery time, that time to decompress. We inherently, Dakota Potter is just joined us from Veterans of Comedy. He's one of the stand-up comedians that can be at Warrior Fest.
Cool.
But we as veterans, we as people need time to decompress, collect our thoughts, figure out what our next step is. If it takes you 10 minutes, fine. If it takes you 10 hours, fine. Take the time for yourself.
On the same side, understand something. If it don't go your way, don't baby about it either.
Right.
You got to learn Maybe you need to learn some new techniques to roll with the punches a little better.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You do. You had to readjust your line of thinking. Mm-hmm. I obviously had to readjust my line of thinking. You know, shitting in cop cars is not the way to be in life. Right. I had to readjust all that. Guys, sometimes, you know what? It's like a football team. Maybe these guys have a successful offense, and every week they just dominate everybody. Or maybe one week they run into a defense that's just beating the crap out of them.
Right.
Half time, they go back and make an adjustment. Come back out. They get the ball. They go down there. They finally win the game. It was a struggle, but they pulled. At the end, they won the game. That's the way we are in life, guys. We have to readjust our thinking.
Right.
I'm not saying abandon your principles. Unless right. you're a pedophile, then you shoot yourself. But if re-abandon your...
We won't get into that.
Right. But you got to reevaluate and adjust. And there's new tools. Your life has changed.
Right.
The man or woman you were before you went in service is not the one to come out.
Right. Well, and right there.
Things are different.
That comment right there from Aunt Belinda again. You want to know somebody who can literally tell you every...
Well, thank you, Belinda. I don't know you, but I appreciate the kind words about me.
One of the very few individuals in my life that has actually, aside from my mother, who has literally watched me go from that person that was before the Marine Corps
right.
to that person during the Marine Corps. And then, oh, you know, my boss just chimed in.
Oh, matter of fact, I seen your boss.
Hey, baby. But, yeah, she said she was talking to you, I think, yeah. yesterday.
My wife. And
but, yeah. but.
Thursday, yeah.
I don't think oh, Thursday, yes, whatever.
Yeah. Hello, memory more.
But she literally, you know, Aunt Belinda has seen me go from the boy that left for the Marine Corps to the Marine to the depressed, broken down man to what I am now. And it's crazy for me to think back because I'm still changing. I'm still learning to deal with a lot of the things that I deal with. You know, Rachel helps me out a lot. You know, she's there for me. She, you know, if it gets to a point where I'm getting overwhelmed or whatever, she will call one of my veteran friends to come over and chill with me. Mm-hmm. You know, she gets to the point where, you know, and she knows it before I know it.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
She'll ask me 2 or 3 days before I have an actual, you know, panic attack or whatever. She'll be, you okay? Yeah, I'm fine. Why?
So you got a good partner in life.
You know, and
who's there? That's very important.
You know, so it's one of those things that you know, and I really wish I could convince her to come on the show one day, but she won't do it. She just won't. But you know, it's one of those, and I really want to get her on mainly because of her standpoint from the spousal side of dealing with this thing.
Yeah.
You know, because she's not perfect, and she'll admit that she's not perfect. She's learned over the past 7 years, 7 freaking years she's been dealing with my ass.
My wife's 16 with me.
Well, there you go. But, you know, it's one of those things. If she could give, because she's, you know, we were talking about it yesterday. She's learned over time. There's that time thing again, that T word, that time word we keep on using. Over time, she has learned how to help me, what she can do to aid me better, you know. And I'm, and this isn't the Justin show. I'm not trying to, you know, but the same thing with Shelly, right?
Oh, absolutely. My wife.
I guarantee if we brought Shelly on, she'd say, day one, she didn't know how to deal with you. Now, here we are at 16 plus years.
Yeah. I've also changed, and she had to change, and we both changed together.
Right.
Made a conscious effort. My wife does kind of the same thing yours does. Mm-hmm. I get in line, my wife calls one person.
Mm-hmm. Your dad?
Yeah, the only man that can get in my face and keep his teeth.
Right.
Okay? And I'm going to tell you something. That man don't sugarcoat shit.
Right.
Okay? He'll say, son, you're being a moron, stop it. I said, you know I can whip your old ass, right? And?
But you won't.
He said, and when I recover, I'll be in your ear again. I'm like, mother, son, what the? You know, uh-huh. By that time, you're like, just forget. No, you want me to whip. I ain't doing it. You want me to do it. I ain't doing it.
You know? Yeah. So,
and,
you know.
You're a good and my wife has wrote letters to the VA. When I finally went and swallowed my pride and got evaluated, mm-hmm. my wife was one of the first people who wrote a letter. And she says, I'm keeping my personal opinions out of it. I'm going to tell you what he's like to live with. I don't want him to be my way. I want him to be him. And so she wrote a big old thing.
Right.
And I read it, and it was nothing derogatory, which was awesome. And a woman, she wasn't derogatory. She's, this is what I see. And I didn't realize what she seen until she put it on paper. And I read it. I'm thinking, oh, okay. You know, how my highs were high and how my lows are low. And I didn't have no middle.
Right.
Okay. I was either bang or bang.
Right.
Now, and they misdiagnosed me, as you know, until here recently. All these years they were treating me for one thing that I don't even have. They finally got me. I'm more stable now than I've been in years. But she knew the right evidence. She stood right there. She, you know, a lot of women, and I don't, please, women, don't take this the wrong way. I don't mean disrespectful, but I'm going to say it. A lot of women will bail, and so will men. Men bail. Not a spouse. I'm going to put it this way. A lot of partners bail on each other because they're not in there for the long haul. My wife has earned her stripes, and I love her death. And I've never bailed on her for her injuries. You know, she never bailed on me for my injuries. Now, sometimes when you don't set the ladder up right and you fall off, she says, you're a knucklehead. You know, she could have.
You're a knucklehead.
You know better than
we
all
need,
this
stuff. We need a Frank Caliendo button there.
Yeah.
For,
yeah.
You're a knucklehead.
Yeah. But that goes back to what we were saying.
Right.
Surround yourself with quality people. My first wife, I wouldn't give you 10 cents to piss on her. I mean, she got so damn big, I wouldn't take her fat ass down to Selborne and get an estimate.
Oh,
that's how bad I hate her. Okay. However, she's the mother of one of my sons. I think. Anyway.
Right. Well,
but she, her and I were just talking about it. Shelly and I are, you know, like you and Rachel.
Right.
Surround
yourself. And don't get me wrong. Me and Rachel do have our battles.
Oh, so well, you're married. But, you do.
You know,
two adults live in the same house for many years.
You're going to butt heads.
Yeah.
You just learn what buttons to push.
But
then it becomes a game.
But anyway. But then at nighttime, you hear Clarence Carter. When I make love. I just don't make love. I be stroking.
Yeah. Belinda just put something in there, and it makes perfect sense, and I love what she said. My struggle was different from yours, but I'm no stranger to PTS and suicide. Can't imagine what our veterans and their families deal with on a daily basis. I'm paraphrasing that, but you don't know that person's journey until you've been on it. Exactly, and that's the thing. You know, I don't know.
Everybody handles the journey different.
You know, Gary Whitten just joined us. I don't know what Gary Whitten has gone through in his life.
Yeah, no idea.
But
nobody knew you. What you going to? You told us.
Right. I can empathize with what he's gone through. I can say, you know what? I haven't been there, but if you need an ear, I'm here. Just like with Stan just a little bit ago. You know, Stan was talking about feeling numb. What did I do? I actually replied to him, and I gave him my personal cell number.
And everybody on here should have been replying to the guy.
Right.
You know we're
and
family,
so,
man. Family.
So, you know, and you know what? Beyond veteran, well, I'm going to throw the veteran side of it out for right now, okay? And I'm about to take my hat off and show my bald-ass head. We're human, okay? At the end of the day, it does not matter. If you cut me, I bleed red. If I cut one of you, you bleed red. Stop this infighting between each other. There's no reason for it. You talk shit about each other, and then you turn around and, oh, yeah, I love you. No, that's not the way to be. We need to support each other, whether our religious, political, moral, or favorite sports teams are different. It doesn't matter. We need to be there for each other. Richie and I, we don't see eye to eye on everything. But I'm going to support him if he needs me, because he's another person. I don't care what your religious background is. I don't care what your ethnic background is. I don't care what your political beliefs are. Anybody who watches this show knows
who your lousy sports team is.
Right. You know, I know. You know what? My sports team will never disappoint me. You know why? Because I know they're going to get to the playoffs and then they're going to choke.
Suck.
So whatever. Okay. They're never going to disappoint me. All right.
And one of the ways I engage people when I'm out somewhere, I watch where they. I'm a observant guy, so I watch how they dress. And if they come in with some Royals gear on, right, I say, hey, I can tell you're a very patient person. I'm like, really? Dude, how do you know I am very patient? How do you know that? Your shirt. You're like, oh, that's fucked up. All of a sudden, they're cussing.
But it's funny.
There's a guy gave $5. He came out and goes, man, that's bullshit. Here. How'd you, man? I said, why are you laughing inside? Because it's funny.
Exactly.
Damn Royals. It ain't my fault they suck.
So, you know, and it's one of those things that at the end of the day, okay, if it's midnight and I just, you know, wake up wigging the hell out for some reason and I call you, yeah, you're going to be grumpy because I woke you up. But are you going to listen because I need to talk?
Mm-hmm.
And I'll do the same thing.
Put you on speakerphone, fall asleep, catch you in the morning.
Yeah. No, I'll be sitting there and get Richie.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, and here's the thing. The greatest part of living your life, and here's the thing. What is the that song? It's a country song. It says, life ain't always beautiful, but it's a beautiful ride.
I don't know. Is Bo Sivas singing it?
No.
Oh, I don't know.
You got to listen to something besides Bo Sivas.
I do it waiting.
Okay, well, this is a newer country artist.
Oh.
Newer than Bo Sivas and Waylon. Okay. I think it was a Gary Allen song. But it says, life ain't always beautiful, but it's a beautiful ride. And let me tell you something, okay? We've seen some pretty messed up stuff.
Yeah.
Am I in the ballpark of being right there?
You're right. I've never really told anybody this story about things that happened to me, but someday I will.
Right.
I just ain't ready to tell everybody yet. But,
well, that's fine.
But I've seen some shit that
like
a grown man.
But think about it, okay? We've seen in our lives, okay, and it doesn't matter who you are, okay, everybody has seen their fair share of bad.
Military or not.
Exactly.
We're talking to the general population.
General population of the United States. And because that's, well, and Australia now, because, you know, Bill Gammon, you know.
Got us some fans over, mate.
Yeah. Get some more fans from down under.
We'll have a party.
You know, we need some more Woe Radio Show fans down under.
Get some Fosters.
Australian for beer. No. I had an Australian buddy that said no, they don't drink Fosters. So, you know, and it doesn't matter if you're a person. You've seen something bad, whether it's a car accident, whether it's your dog died, or whether it's, you know, something horrible, okay? You have seen your share of bad. Own it, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Don't concentrate on it, okay? Try not to get in. And I'm guilty of this, okay? So I'm preaching to the choir here, okay? Don't concentrate on it. Don't dwell on it, but own it. Own your shit, okay?
Yeah,
own your bad.
It's very.
But turn around and concentrate on the good.
Do. Yeah, very hard to do. Like this whole thing when I fell, I'm now in the mental stage of this thing. I'm thinking, why? I know why.
Right.
And I cussed up, I know better, you know better, blah, blah, blah. And then I started to think about the other part of this fall, the part that scared me to death. And not a lot of things scare me, but I'm going to admit to this. When I was in the air, hanging, I hung in the air.
Like that slow motion fall almost?
I was so high that when you, no, I mean, I'm not, I mean, high in the air.
Yeah.
When I came down, I hung there. I seen everything coming. That's one of the scariest parts of your life because you have no idea what to do.
Right, yeah.
And people are like, won't you tuck and roll? Won't you kiss my ass? I'm 20 feet in the air. I ain't tucking and rolling crap. I'm trying to roll and stay alive. Look, my goal is to live.
Right. Yeah.
But you don't know, and my feet went on the ground.
It
was a surreal moment in my life.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, crap, it's gonna hurt. Well, I got one part right.
Yeah. So.
You know. And that scared the crap out of me.
Do me a favor. Run with it for a couple of minutes.
And that scared the crap out of me. You know, I'm not going to be afraid of a ladder, although my uncle tried to tell me I should call the insurance company and say every time I go near a ladder, I piss my pants. But no, I'm not going to be doing all that. The only beer cool enough to come in an oil can. Sweet, sweet. So, surround yourself with good people. Okay. That was one of the best pieces of advice any therapist worth their salt, any counselor worth their salt will tell you the same thing. I've gained a new bunch of friends just being on here that I never knew in my life. I still got my old friends. You know, actually, that's kind of a bad term. There's no such thing as old friends. They're still your friends. But I got some newer friends, okay? You guys, I go back. I got a lot. You know, my brain runs fast. Everything runs through my head, right? And I always go back and I read your comments and I try to, you know, figure out what I can do better for y'all. You know, my jokes, I try to tweak them. I go back and I watch myself tell jokes. Not because I'm narcissistic. It's because I'm trying to, if I want to tweak a joke left or, you know, something like that. And I go back on here and I read your comments and you guys are beautiful people. But people are afraid to help other people. And I notice it. And I know veterans are quick to help veterans. Not a lot of people won't. I really don't know why. People talk a good talk. You know, I had a lady come up to me when I was on location, and she's always like, you know, the government don't do enough for you guys. The government needs to do this. And the whole time talking, she never one time donated a dollar bill, 50 cent, nothing. Not one time she donated. But she had good advice about how to get donations, but she never donated. And it just went on and on and on and on and on with her. And I got to thinking, you know, why isn't she doing what she's preaching? Well, a veteran walked right around and a veteran, hey, devil dog, or another veteran, hey, I was Army Ranger, man. And you get to talk to them, and pretty soon they're coming off the cash and put it in there for the donation. Okay. And I'm not saying it to be greedy. What I'm trying is I'm illustrating is veterans help other veterans quicker than anybody else will. Because we know we've been there. And so help your fellow neighbor, help your fellow veteran. Surround yourself with quality people who say, you know, I'm not gonna allow you hurt yourself today. I'm not gonna allow you to hurt anyone else today. I'm not, you know, what can I do to help you? And that's what it should be in life. You know, people worry about all these dumbass challenges we got, the tie pole challenge, the set yourself on fire. And by the way, the set yourself on fire challenges are stupid. Okay. You might think your body's flame retardant, but I'm pretty sure you're retarded for doing that. That's just dumb. But people concentrate on all these challenges and everything to bring it together. Nah, man. Whatever happened to days where you go to somebody's house, you have barbecue, and you have block parties. You know, the kids all play with other kids. You get to know other kids, black kids, white kids, Mexican kids, Puerto Rican kids. Okay? The parents don't know each other. Well, in my day, if you were a group of kids, you did something, y'all got your ass whipped by that parent. And then you went over home to what happened? Your parents whipped your ass and their ass. And there's like 9 ass whippings handed out. For one thing, I guarantee you, when they were
done, if you started at one end of the block, you're getting your ass whipped by every house on the way to
and
house.
It wasn't abuse. It was an ass whipping, and you went on. Okay?
Yep.
And guys, let me go a little further here. We make laws in this country. Well, some people make laws for us, and a lot of these laws I don't understand. We never voted on them, never wanted them. But there's laws in this country that hurt the modern citizen. You know, and if they're hurting the citizen, what the hell? Do they really have our best interest at heart? Okay, now I understand. Let's take a stolen property. Let's take stolen property, for example. If you buy a piece of stolen property and you don't know it's stolen,
right,
you lose your money, you lose that piece of property, and your ass going to jail.
Right.
What kind Whether of hood I know
it's stolen. Yeah, yeah. It's
what
messed
kind
up.
Of hood and if they write you a fake bill of sale, you're still going to jail. How the hell you know? Are you a mind reader?
Yeah.
There's laws like that hurt us. There's a law in the state of Missouri that says they cannot shut your power off if it's below 32 degrees for one 24 consecutive period. Okay, they do it anyway. They do it anyway. Well, I don't pertain to us. We're a private company. It doesn't matter. The law says they can't do it. They do it anyway. Why aren't you enforcing these laws? Why? And why are you letting them, somebody who, an old lady or someone's going to fix them, get $1,500 behind anyway?
Right.
You know, I got to have the whole $1,500. They didn't have the $1,500 to pay you.
Right.
They're not going to have $1,500 to turn you back on.
Right.
Oh, then they want a $50 deposit. Why? If I can't give you $1,500, why do you need another $54? $1,500 will clear my account. Let's go. That's the way, in these laws, we treat each other like that. And right. The governments, they label each other. Black man, white man. You know, the black man committed most crime. Why don't you just say this guy committed.
Committed a crime.
You want us to stop labeling each other. It starts at the top.
Oh, yeah.
And as long as the government's labeling us, no wonder we can't get along.
Right.
Oh, you're Native American? Oh, you probably live in a teepee. bitch, I got a big house. Oh, I don't damn TP. I got a squall too. She's German. You know what the hell? Does that guy do shit? Oh, you're a white guy. Oh, so you're probably more like a check writing and pedophile crime. Or you're black, you're probably more of a thug. I see more thugs white.
Those are wannabe thugs.
You know, either way, they're still going to prison meet Bubba. Yeah. You know, what the hell? We got to start labeling each other and start walking the path together. Now, don't get me wrong. There is people of color who are messed up. I got a family full of rednecks who... I got a cousin who just loves being in prison, I guess. No, I'm going to tell you a little story. This is a true story. You can verify this. This ignorant son of a... Let me refocus. He goes to the local junkyard. Matter of fact, he lives in three towns away. He came to this town wearing around a camera, to the junkyard.
Right.
He walks by the camera, waves at the camera, full facial. Waves at the camera. Walks in the junkyard, steals 4 aluminum mag wheels for his car. Takes out the first 2. Okay. Walks back, waves at the camera again, grabs the second 2. Comes back. If I'm dying, a lot of people will hit me right now. He makes out an IOU. My name is Michael Lee King. Date of birth, blah, 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 blah. Social security number, blah, 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 blah. OU for 1 set of mag wheels. Address, gives him his home address. God bless. Hangs it on the freaking door. Okay.
What did he think was going to happen?
Waved at the camera, backed up. They got a perfect shot of his. I mean, you couldn't ask for better forensic evidence, okay? He got his plate number, right? He goes to court. I had to go see the goings-ons. I didn't believe this. I'm in there watching this stuff. The judge looked at him like, and the judge wanted to say something else, but he didn't. He goes, are you, really? He just looked at him and said, really? I'm over looking like, yeah, really? He said, well, you know. Judge said, what'd you do with the rims? You still got them? Oh, yeah, I had them mounted and put on my car. And he was just very excited about it. Just like, how many times you been? I started looking at how many times he'd been in jail. I'm thinking, where's that 3-strike rule at? What the hell happened to that? Stuff like that. What do you think was going to happen to him?
Yeah, I don't know.
It says in letters, surveillance camera.
Right.
What? So you got, everybody's got people like that in their family. What do you do? We got to love each other and get along. People have people make mistakes and get over. You know, I'm there for him, even though he's dumb. And I don't trust him in my house. Right. But he's my family. I'm there for if he needs me. We gotta be like it with people. We have to.
Yeah.
I'm not telling you don't know. You know, maybe I shouldn't surround myself with him. He's still my family, but right. I don't have him on barbecues. Okay. But there's other people in my family I would.
Well, no, because shit will come up missing.
Yeah. He's got a spot and steal company. Right. One guy spots it, he steals it. You know,
right.
Spot. You, I mean, you're invited. I invite people 4th of July. People have things to do, fine. But I invite them. They're welcome to my house. I have a big party every year, 4th of July. Big blowout.
And you blow stuff up.
That's one of my crutches. I love that Tannerite.
But
we got it. But we got to take care of our veterans, guys. Stan, I hope you're still on here, and I hope you're doing good, brother. Laugh a little bit.
Yeah.
Love.
Have a little fun.
You wear a size 4X t-shirt. You're a big man. I know you love the groceries. If you like a good meal, eat a good meal. Ain't nothing wrong. Who gives a shit? Eat it. Eat it.
I've missed a lot of things in life, but I've never missed a dessert.
I ain't never been sideways of a dessert I didn't like.
Anyway,
I didn't mean to rant, but go ahead like that, bro.
Real quick, Aunt Belinda had surgery on both of her feet yesterday, so we do wish her speedy recovery.
Don't let them get some Oxycontin. Or Oxys. Both Oxycodone, Oxycontin. Just
one of them.
Percocet. Brr.
Yeah, Richie should do it last week on the show. Richie was
I went back and looked at that.
Oh man.
I didn't know it. Did you see my face?
You were lost. You didn't know where the hell you were.
I was sitting in a chair, had a phone in here. I didn't know what the hell you all talking about half the time. I swear to God, I thought them hummingbirds were after me. I went back looking, holy crap, the EPA's gonna shut him down.
Oh, Stan says, come on down, I make bean barbecue.
There you go, brother.
He might have a housemate for a couple weeks.
We'll go try to get that way. You just be on the lookout. And this is to everybody, not just Stan. You guys be on the lookout. We're liable to show up somewhere, Comedy Vets or the show or whatever. Because Justin overlaps sometimes, too. Sometimes he's a pitcher. He's our front man. Sometimes the MC guy, you know, on there as well. So you're liable to see us
just anywhere. About anywhere.
And we'll have a good time. We'll do the shenanigans we do now, talk some crap that probably four-fifths of them are lies, and tell jokes, just hang out.
Did you just say four-fifths?
Yeah, is that not a mathematical equation?
Yeah, that is, but it's just like the randomness thing. Like, not most people say nine-tenths of them instead of four-fifths. So it's just
random. What is four-fifths anyway? It's
four-fifths.
Of a what?
Of a whole.
Of a tenth?
No.
Of a unit?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Anyway, so
Jesus Christ. Carpenter for 25 years, won awards for carpentership. Can't do math to save my life.
Oh, good Lord. Richie.
Builds you a nice square house, a beautiful deck, and all the drywall work, but can't add two.
Can't add two and two for shit. But anyway, well, you know what that new Common Core math, it's like 2 + 2 equals fish.
Yeah, whatever.
So, but anyway.
6 and 2 is 8 and farts a fracture. So what the
hell? Stan Moore, apparently he likes fifths of Jim, Jack, Johnny.
Next to Jay.
Jose.
JJ's.
Jose.
Bourbon, scotch, and tequila.
There you go.
That's what you're
doing. But anyway, so and actually, here on the show, we don't really drink that much.
I quit.
Like, I will have a beer or two every once in a while. You know, I might have a shot of something or, but I just don't. Like, if somebody offers it, I'll sit down and have a beer with somebody or, I've already said, a couple of guys at Warrior Fest want to sit down and have a beer or whatnot.
I'm having a beer at Warrior Fest now.
Yeah, I'll sit down and have a beer with everybody there.
Yeah.
But
my wife, by the way,
uh-oh,
she's coming to Warrior Fest because she's telling us there's going to be a massive amount of shenanigans that her husband's going to be involved in.
Yeah.
And she laid down some rules.
Uh-oh.
You ain't getting no effing ladder and changing no light bulbs. They got maintenance men for that. Keep your fat ass off the ladder. And now my wife starts using the word fat ass. She's making a point right to it.
Right.
Keep your fat ass off the ladder. Baby, it's only
20. Rachel's.
Shut up.
It's only 2 feet. It's a three stepper.
You want to walk?
But no.
Do it look like I walk anywhere?
No. Right.
So, but anyway, she wants to come up
Rachel's
here. So she's going to
be there.
Too. You come out and meet the saint. I call her. Everybody calls her the saint that knows her. Like, how the hell are you married to him? You must have patience of a saint. So
I'm waiting for somebody to give Rachel a name like that for dealing with me for 7 years so far. I mean, and I love her. And she knows I love her. I don't know how she does it.
Maybe she's a little off too. They say it takes a crook to catch a crook.
Yeah,
It takes a psycho to do a psycho.
I guess. But anyway, so we're down to the last 10 minutes ish of the show, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I know we say it every week, but you're not worthless.
Man, you
okay,
are so nice.
And we don't just say it because
the first day I joined you in the studio, you said that. The first day I joined you in the studio upstairs, you said that. I wrote that on the board and it's still there.
Yep, it stays up there. But you just remember, you are not worthless. You have value. There is something that you can offer. Maybe you haven't found it yet. Maybe it's a listening ear. Maybe it's bringing comedy to people. Maybe it's bringing information to people. Maybe it's just being who you are for other people. You have value. Work at it. Try and find what you have to offer. Everybody has something. You might be the best carpenter in the world. You might be the best guitar player ever. You might be somebody who can write poetry and just, you know what I mean? There is so much that can be, I don't even have words, honestly, to describe what it takes. You know, Rachel, Shelley, Stan's wife, they deal with us, and we jokingly say they deal with us. They support us. Because
they want you, not
because
they have to.
Exactly, yeah. Because they don't have to be here. You know, that's the thing. Rachel doesn't have to be with me. The my mom doesn't have to deal with me. My Aunt Belinda doesn't have to deal with me. But they do because they love me and because they want to be there for us. So...
Well, like and share the page, guys. Like and share the hell out of this. Yeah. We was up to 7 shares a while ago. Like and share this so people can watch this during the week. A lot of our viewers watch during the week. You know, we might leave here with 6 views, right. but by the end, to close the business today and tomorrow week, we'll build up. And so we thank you all for doing that because I know everybody's busy and got lives.
Right.
But share the hell out of this, guys. Get this out there. Stan, we want to make Stan a household name for this next coming up show. By the way, we come to the show next weekend, we want Stan to say, hey, man, thank you, guys.
And I'm going to kill you because my box is
blown. And I'm whipping both your asses when I see it. But I want you guys to show Stan some love and show each other some love. Share this. Get this out there. Mm-hmm. We're not getting a check.
Nope.
And we are poor. We sure love a check, but we don't get a check for this.
Right.
We do it because somebody says, hey, thank you. Hey, I seen your show. Man, you're a funny dude. Thank you.
You know, somebody says, you know, hey, I was listening to the show or whatnot. You know, what you guys said really made an impact on me. That right there is a paycheck enough for me. So,
and Stan, you're not the first guy who's turned out to us like that. Yeah, we made him feel good. Yeah. And now we've got a few followers who did the same thing, and now they listen to us every week. So,
right.
Don't be a stranger, Stan.
I kind of got ostracized last week because I wasn't watching the comments enough, and I apologize. We don't always catch every comment.
Dude, we're lucky to read.
Right. You know, a lot of times we're lucky to catch any. But with that being said, guys, if you want to support the show, like I said, $20. Well, $25 with shipping and handling. PayPal, through PayPal, thewoeradioshow@gmail.com. That'll get you your shirt. And I think Tumblr, because we still got the Tumblrs too.
Or the
whatever the hell they're called.
Grinders,
growler, whatever. Yeah. It'll get you your shirt. It'll get you your growler from St. Joe Casino. The if you want Warrior Fest tickets, it's $30. Send it to the same PayPal, thewoeradioshow@gmail.com. All of that, make sure we get your name and your address so that we can send you the hard copy ticket whenever it comes in.
Yes.
Just
like you do the football games now. Have that in
hand.
Or
so that we can have your name on the list at the door. You know, the day of. If you're only going to attend one day, okay? If you're only going to attend one day, it's $15. So make sure you decide accordingly and go from there. Make sure you put down the names of everybody you're buying tickets for. So if you buy 2 people for one day, it's $30, but I need their names so that both of you can get in.
Right.
The
veterans have your credentials.
Veterans have your credentials because you're half price for both days.
We've been telling you for a long time, so don't forget. Have your
right, and you don't have to pre-order tickets.
No, just
at the door. Okay. Right. So with that being said, guys, thank you to all of us.
Thank you to. We want to mention Catholic Charities. We almost forgot. You know, they support us. If there's one in your area and you're having problems, Stan, remember, Catholic Charities. If all else fails, brother, go find you a Catholic Charities in your area.
Yep.
They support our show. They love us. We love them. They're good folks. Talk with them. They'll provide you with sleeping quarters. I mean, they give you a water bottle when you go in with toothbrush, toothpaste, shampoo, conditioner, business card. You get a hold of somebody, ink pen to write, look for jobs, whatever. Catholic Charities in your area. Sorry, brother.
Right. You're fine. Final thoughts. I do need to thank our sponsors, Grunt Style, WarriorPoint with an E.org. Head over, become one of the uncommon few. Another resource in the toolbox, another tool in the toolbox for us vets that are trying to navigate through this crazy life we have.
Right.
And then All-Star Rock Bar down in Kansas City, Lux Construction.
We're coming.
And we're going to blow the roof off that place. So, you know, Lux
Construction. I apologize ahead of time.
And you know what? BV Nation, I'm gonna mention them as a sponsor because they do help us out a lot.
Oh, man, I tell you what, they've been really good.
You know? Make sure you check out BV Nation.
They could have said, just go hump yourselves. You got to figure it out.
Yeah.
Been some good
So make sure you check out BV Nation tomorrow night. They're phenomenal guys.
Prepare to stay
tonight,
up late.
Make sure you, prepare to, if you're Central Time, you're going to stay up late. Make sure you check out 1700 somewhere tonight with Athen and the crew.
That's right.
They've always got some good stuff, and it's always fun to laugh at their technical difficulties because we do the same deal with the same stuff.
That's
so,
right.
Much love to everybody, guys. Like I said, you are not worthless.
Right.
Remember that. Please don't ever think you are not that you are worthless. Okay, I deal with it. I know Richie probably deals with it from time to time.
Mm-hmm.
It, just remember, there's always somebody that's willing to help. There's always somebody that's willing to talk. Stan, Mom, Belinda, Rachel, Shelley, everybody that's tuned in today, thank you guys so much. Okay, we love you guys. We'll see you guys next week right here, same time, same channel. We'll talk to you later.